Can you read aloud in your Bible? Use English.
Matthew 1.
Verse 1. It says what?
Matthew
1.
1.
Verse what? 1. It says, this is a record of ancestors of Jesus the Messiah, a descendant of David and of Abraham.
Amen.
Can you see the verse there? Read 18. Or the same chapter. It says what? Read, Mama.
This is how Jesus the Messiah was born. His mother, Mary, was engaged to be married to Joseph. But before the marriage took place, while she was still a virgin, she became pregnant through the power of the Holy Spirit.
Read until 23.
Joseph, her fiancé, was a good man and did not want to disgrace her publicly. So he decided to break the engagement quietly. As he considered this, and an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream. Joseph, son of David, the angel said, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child within her was conceived by the Holy Spirit, and she will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. All of this occurred to fulfill the Lord's message through his prophet.
23.
Look, the virgin will conceive a child. She will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God is with us.
Let us pray. Father, thank you for your word. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I want us to know that this is your message of the Christmas that is coming. I was learning about the genealogy of Jesus. I found that it was important for us to know. You know, we are living in this world whereby when somebody meets you, will never ask you about your father. The person will ask you about your career. Will ask you about, you know, what are you doing in life? By the time of Jesus, it was important to name someone because of where he came from. My topic today is, who is your father? Who is your father? Because when Jesus was living on earth, there were a lot of questions about him. And now we hear the genealogy of Jesus that is on the line of David.
There are
two people have been mentioned. It is Abraham and David. Abraham, the man that of faith, the father of faith.
Abraham,
Jesus is coming from there, where faith must be practiced. David was the king of Israel.
Israel.
Where Jesus is coming from, the lineage of a king, meaning he's a king.
Mo Jesu atangonai, ona le lukula di khoshi, ora uri ki khoshi.
When you say Jesus, son of David, you are saying, Jesus, you are a king.
So by
the time when Jesus was born,
the
expectations in
Israel
was of Jerusalem not in Galilee.
Ne ilitaba ya Jerusalem haiko Galilea.
So go so that if he can be born in Jerusalem, Herod will kill him.
Herod,
I don't know if you're hearing that. So he makes sure that he was born outside. Though he is in the lineage of the king, he was born as a king. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He is called King of Kings. When we read about him, the Bible says, when he came,
there were
signs of him coming to prove that there's a king who was born. Now, when he was living on earth, because God used his own way, a king that was born outside of
Jerusalem,
a king who came not because of their expectation. Everybody questioned him. Who is this man? Who is his father? I'm sure you're hearing that.
Pastor,
who is your father? Jesus faced the same. So now people knew him. That is the son of Mary and
Joseph.
When he was growing, the father was a carpenter. Remember the Bible talks about how he was born. And he says already Mary was found with pregnancy.
Maria uno tholagala seja imile.
You know, when I read that, I was asking myself, that were they having machines?
Ore ne ona le michini ye re nang le yona ya machachi a na jwale.
Because now you can know you're pregnant with 6 weeks. But that time, the Bible says he was found with a child. It means the stomach boom. Because of the Holy Spirit. And this has brought problem. Not only in Israel. Even Joseph. Joseph wanted to run away. But God said, hey, this is the son who's coming from me. Born for this nation. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But they were mistaken. But the time when Jesus was walking, he loved to utter this statement. God is my father. But listen, the Israelites by then, when you say God is your father, we're like taking God as a man. It's like you are kissing God. And these people will kill you. On John 9 verse 4, he says, I will do, that was Jesus, what God sent me. I don't know if you're hearing
this.
Amen. I will do what he sent me. When he teach people what to pray, he says, say you are my father in heaven. Father in heaven.
Papa, wale kotimo.
We have a father.
Renalintate.
I say we have a father.
Renale papa.
And this father,
Enentateo.
He wants us to be like him.
Onyaka rena re swana le yena.
So Jesus had
Jano Jesu na na le mo ba yemi ngona.
Quoting him.
Wa o gona o bolela ka yena.
He says, I do.
Ore a bolela rena ke dira.
What my father want me to do.
Mishumo ye papa nyaka ke dira.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you look at the characters of your father, which we have to be like the children, knowing that he is the father. In Matthew 5:48, he said, be perfect as I'm perfect. He was telling, he said, I'm God,
your father.
Be my child.
Because
I'm your father.
For
you to show that you are my son or my daughter,
be perfect.
Because I'm perfect. In Luke 6 verse 36. He said, be merciful. Because I'm merciful. Be like me. Full of mercy. And even you be full of mercy. Listen, you can't tell person who's merciful to forgive. Always he forgives. If you want to see your father, you take the character of him. You live like him. Jesus lived, showing that it's not him doing what he's doing. It's his father. I don't know if you're hearing me. When we look at you, we are seeing a copy of your father. Let me take you back. By the time of Saul, if you can read the Bible, in
1
Samuel
9, 10, 9
to 12. 1 Samuel chapter 10,
Samuel wapili chapter 10,
verse 9 to 12.
Lebale verse 9 le 12.
If you read there, you'll find the Bible shows that Saul was a son of Kish.
Or Saul na le mura wa Kish.
But now,
Marajano,
when he turned from Samuel, he got the spirit of prophecy to extend that the prophets who were with him were questioned, who are the father of this prophet?
Why?
Because they knew Saul, that he was not fit to be a prophet. And this brought a question of other prophets where we saw. I don't know if you're hearing me. The Bible talks about Saul prophesying
with the prophets
to extend that people could not ask Saul. They questioned the prophets and say, these prophets, we don't believe in them, because we know Saul and we know his father. I don't know if you're hearing me. Listen, if you walk with wrong people, even your credit or your ability, or your behavior, or your character, it's questioned. I don't know if you're hearing me. If you come to charity here, and people think we are
fake,
even you are a fake. I don't know if you're hearing me. Listen, the prophets were questioned. These prophets, they are with Saul. Is Saul among the prophets? Who are their fathers? Because we know Kish. I don't know if you're hearing me. Listen, your ability of doing things is referred back to your father. I don't know if you're hearing me. If you are failing in life, they won't come and tell you. Those who know your father will tell you that even your father was a failure. We are not surprised of you. I don't know if you're hearing me.
Amen.
But when you meet a prophet, it's possible that when you turn from here, people begin to question you and say, where did you get that ability? Despise, you are born in a family of failure. But if you meet a prophet like Samuel, when you turn from here, people are going to be surprised among you. Why? Because you'll be doing things that they know you can't do. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
Ask say, my friend, your ability is being limited to the one who gave birth to you. People can come and say, we know you because of your father. You know, one time, I'm not trying to be funny to you, but I want to tell you
what happened.
When I was 16, 17 years, I love fighting a lot. In fact, I love fighting until maybe fighting until morning. Or fighting.
It's
to extent that when you hit me, I love it so much. So one time I was arrested. When I was arrested, I was in prison, so we used to fight there. There was another boss. Everybody was respecting myself. I was just living my life there. So I didn't know that there was somebody who knows my father. So one time, already we are arrested. We are wearing those funny clothes. And then when I was moving outside, I heard this man coming to call me. He said to me, you know, you can do better. You can do better. I know your father. You can do better. You are just walking straight where your father walks. You love fighting. Now even yourself, you need God. You can do better. I don't know if you are hearing me. I look at myself. I feel I can't listen to this
one.
I asked this man, I said, how do you know me? He said, I know your father when he's still a police in Freistadt. I didn't even know my father was a police. And I was feeling very bad. You know, when I come out, I went to my mom and asked mama, was my father be a police? He says, yes, in Johannesburg. I said, where? He said, on the side of Freistadt. And I said, oh,
okay.
I don't want to be like my father. That man said, I can do better. I'm here with the same message. If you live like your father, you are a failure. Even your father wants you to do better. Tell
them,
my friends, you can do better. You can do better than your father. Because your father is Jehovah. Your father is Jehovah. Tell them, my friend, you can do better. Because your father is Jehovah. You need to have
Jesus.
If you read Luke 11, Verse 47 to 48. It shows that we always continue with what our father has started. Jesus said that, you people, your fathers killed the prophets, but you make tombstones. It means we continue with what our father did. God wants us to do better. Not to continue in wrong things. If we believe God is our father, we will walk like him. We will talk like him. We will act like him. And we will have results like him. Shake somebody, say, my friend, God is my father. Say, God is my father. Jesus said, your fathers seen from the beginning, and you are continuing to see. In Acts 7:51, the Bible says, when Stephen was speaking, he says, you resist the Holy Spirit as your father did. Meaning that we are not different with the natural fathers we are having. It's only when Jesus comes that we resemble our father in heaven. I don't know if you're hearing me. When you live from here, don't judge your parents. Know that God is your father. And if you know God is your father, know that Jesus came for that. Jesus came so that he becomes our elder brother. He came so that we live like him. When he left, he said, we will do what he did, and we will do above. Shake someone, my friend. If God is your father, you will do what Jesus did, and you will do above. Shake someone and say, hey, don't judge yourself by your failures. God is your father. Ask your neighbor, who's your father? You must check. Listen. One time, I found that our resemblance are not new. You look like someone because you have the blood of your father. I don't know if you're hearing me. And I realized that if now I have God's blood, the blood of
Jesus,
I must look like
Jesus.
I must do what Jesus did. I don't know if you're hearing me. You know, today I want to do what Jesus did. From now, because I know God is my father. One time when Jesus was revealing the secrets to the disciples, when Judas was gone, he looked up and said, I thank you, Father. If we address God as our Father, there are prayers we won't pray. If you remember Matthew 6 verse
6,
it shows that our Father knows what we need before we ask him. You will stop asking him things because you know God is your Father. I don't know if you're hearing me. Your prayer will base on fellowship. Not because you are asking things. Because you know it's your Father. Whatever belongs to your Father belongs to you. Jesus was born and he was called
Emmanuel.
Because Jesus is God. As a son of God, he was called God is with us. In Matthew 6 verse 6 to 8, he says we must be different with them. Why? Because we have a Father. We must be different with them. We have a Father. I don't know if you're hearing me. If you read verse 7 in Matthew 6 there.
Matthew 6 verse 7.
Let's go there.
Verse 7,
he says, when you pray, don't babble on and on as people of other regions do. He says we must not pray like that. I must say, Father, I want to see this. And I believe it's done. I don't know if you are hearing me. Stop babbling like that. Stop talking like you can't, your father can't hear you. Look at verse 8. He says, don't be like them, for your father knows exactly what you need even before you ask him. Don't be like them. Even if you are not praying, your father can satisfy you. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
In Luke 12, verse 25 to 30.
Luke 12, 25 to 30.
It says your father knows that you have need of those things. There are things you have
got
need. In Luke 7 verse 11, it says, if the evil fathers are taking care of their sons, how much more your father in heaven? We have a father who won't compromise with our needs. If we know Jesus came so that we will know our Father, he said, you can't go to the Father except through me. Jesus said, you know the Father when you know me. If you see me, you are seeing the Father. I don't know if you are hearing me. Are you ready today to call your father to come here? Are you ready today to speak with your father to honor you? Are you ready today? Do you know your father? Ask him, do you know your father? Who is your father? Ask your neighbor, who is your father? Who is your father? Listen to this. Many times we are praying prayer, but we don't have time to talk with our Father. We don't have time to open the Bible and say, Father, in your word here, there is something like this. Can I tell you something that will shock you? Can I tell you something? When you are busy with nothing the whole day of your father, you won't have anything to pray. You know Jesus, why he prayed the whole night? Because during the day, he will see the cripple walking, the blind will be seeing, he will be teaching. When he kneeled before his father, he'll be saying, Father, I spoke about this. And I saw your way. You were healing people. I thank you, Father. I thank you, Father. There are many things you can say. Do you remember the time when Lazarus came forth? He said, Father, I know you hear me. This is not prayer. This shows relationship. There's a relationship of a father and a son to extend that the father will never deny the son on anything. When Jesus asks anything, it will happen in a simple way because there was a father. I don't know if you're hearing me. He said, you can ask the father anything in my name, because I am the son, the father will do it. I don't know if you are hearing me. As I say, my friend, if you are a son or a daughter, your prayer will never be in vain. When you pray, God will hear you because he's your father. I say, it's your father. You have a father. He came so that you change your name. When somebody asks you and rejects you, you tell, you are able to say, I'm Jerry Jehovah. Not Jerry Makananisa. I'm Jerry Jehovah. I know my father. When he's around, I won't fail. I'm Eunice Jehovah. Shake somebody and say, my friend, what is your same name? Who is your father? If you know your father, you will say, I'm seeing my father. He's with me. I won't fail. I won't fail. I'm Jerry Jehovah. I'm Jeremiah Jehovah. Naki Jerry Jehovah. You know, one time, I found that people can still say in that family, all Makaranisa people are failing. I will come up to say, I'm not Makaranisa. I'm from Jehovah. My father is Jehovah. I don't know if you're hearing me.
Ake tsebaga lentwa.
Shake somebody say my friend.
Ako mucho mtule kafuru mkhosi.
Who is your father?
Tsebo tse papa ga o ile re o ke ma.
Listen.
Lalela.
From today.
O tlhola le khono le.
You can break the record of your family.
Wena o ka roba rekoto ya lelapa la geno.
You can live better than your family.
Wena o ka pila ka o no fita bo ntata
ya heno. From today.
O tlhola le khono le.
You can have success.
Wena o ka ba le katheo.
That has never been seen.
E thinking ya bona ga la
batho. You need to know your father.
Wena o tlhola o tseba fela o re tata o ke
ma. Know your father.
Wena tsebo re ntate ke ma.
Know who's your father.
Tsebo re ntata ga o ke ma.
When your father is there.
A ntata liteng.
He will never leave you.
O ka aga tswa o tlhage.
Or forsake you.
Aga tswa o lathile.
When you go home.
A wena o ya gae.
When people look at you.
A batho ba o lebelela.
Just walk like you know.
Wena se pela fela ka ro wa tshe.
Your father is looking on you.
O re ntate o lebeletse.
He knows what you want.
O ya tsebo re wena o nya ka.
Before you ask him.
Wena o so bolele wa gopela.
Don't pray an vain prayer.
Wena o ka dithapelo tja o thoka mogola.
Don't pray a prayer of fear.
O ka rata dithapelo tja o tshuwa tja o tshaba.
Stop praying prayer.
Wena dithapelo
tjela. Like you don't know your father.
O ka ra o motsimi ntate o bolela.
Don't beg your father.
Wena o ska rapeletsa papa o yo rapela.
Don't beg your father.
O ska rapeletsa papa.
He want to give you the kingdom.
Papa o yo go fa muso wo.
He want to give you.
Papa o yo go fa ka mokatse le muso.
Shake say hey.
Ako shishinya mutshole ka
fa. I know my father.
Na papa ka ke a motsiba.
I know my father.
Na papa ka a motsiba.
He will never leave me.
Aka sitse wa ntwele.
I know my father.
Na ntate ke a motsiba.
He's around.
O tla le gaufi le
nna. I know my father.
Na ntate ke a motsiba.
As he said.
Ka le ka ga se tshabuletse.
Heaven and earth belongs to him. Even me, I own where I am. I'm not there because I'm a tool. I've been placed by my father. Listen, next year or from now, when people speak against you, don't even answer them. They don't know your father. I don't know if you're hearing me.
I can say what I can tell
you. They don't know your father.
Papa, I am a TV.
Listen.
Lalela.
Your father can leave
Papa,
them for a while.
Papa, tu wela na konyana ba ipine.
He can leave them.
Akaba tu wela
for a while.
Na konyana.
So that they talk.
Utjelo ba bolela.
What they are talking.
Je ba rata mo di bolela.
Don't answer them.
Wena o ska ba go fetula ne.
Look unto him.
Wena lebella papola wa
hao. The author and the finisher of your faith.
What tumelo ya hao.
When they are talking against you,
hey, khatanong le
wena. Just rejoice.
Wena ipine fela.
Because you know what your father will do.
Tsi gore ntata o tata dia.
He say vengeance is mine.
Tsa mtwa ye ki yaka.
He say vengeance is mine.
Ke nna ya lwa la lwa na na.
He's the Lord who knows you.
Ke modimo ya o tsiba.
He's the Lord who knows you.
Ke modimo ya o tsiba.
He created you.
O ila o hlola wena.
He knows where he's taking you.
Ke tsi gore o tsha o isa kae.
He's your father.
Ke papa wa hao.
Shake some say hey.
Ako shisha mtula
ka. I can see my problem.
Na ke khono bona botata ba.
I know my father. After I found that God is our father, it's not just God there. I change how I pray. There was a time I was saying, this chair belonged to my father. And this one belongs to Jesus. And I say, I'm here. I say, Father. Father.
Papa.
I know I'm asking this in the name of this one. I speak as if they are there. I'm asking this because of Jesus. Jesus.
Jesus way
makes a way for me to come to you so that whatever I ask you do it. I know it's possible because you are the Father. From there I began to thank him. I glorify him. I'm telling you it won't take long. Something happened. I don't know if you're hearing me. I call them dangerous prayer. The moment when I pray this way, something must happen. You hear what I'm trying to say? I don't go to God and say, oh God,
your way.
I don't know what will happen.
No.
My things are so tough.
Oh.
I go to God and say, God, this is your chair. And this one is Jesus. And I can't even look at you. But Jesus made it possible. So that's why I'm looking at you. My Father, let this happen. You'll be surprised it's happening. You'll be surprised it's happening. Do you want to see something happening? Stand up and speak with your Father. Speak with your Father. Are you ready to speak with your Father? Are you ready to speak with your Father? Are you ready to speak with your Father?